There you go. Let's do it quickly. What we plan to do today, guys, let me double check if we are on game capture. Yes, we are. Let me start X-plane11 and then I have to turn it over there because obviously that's the game that we want to capture. I just want to make sure that it's already there. All right, so are you guys here? Hello, nice to have you here if you're here. So what we're gonna do is you have to wait until X-plane11 basically starts up, obviously. What we're gonna do is we're gonna actually try out the, I was told by Julian, my friend, actually, you know what, let me actually double check if maybe he is online in Discord, because that's where, that's the guy who talked to me about it. So I would like him to be there if he is there. Let me see. Oh, the skipjack. Oh wow, beautiful pictures, man. Okay, Julian is, oh, Julian is there. He is actually playing, so let me send a quick message to him. Okay, so first of all, hello guys, if anybody's here. Hey, oh, you're there. Okay, good. I just sent you a Discord message just to double check. So what I'm gonna do, Julian, and everybody else as well, but it's right now doing it pretty much for Julian, is I'm not gonna do like a full flight, unfortunately. I don't have the time for that. However, I'm gonna go to LAX, KLAX, okay, and doesn't matter, let's go for gate 3, let's go for gate T5, gate 51A, whatever, okay, and we're gonna go for the Boeing 700, this one, and we're gonna go for the Delta. It really doesn't matter, I'm just doing it. And everything, the conditions are okay, start the flight. And we're gonna actually load up, hold on. Ignore. Shit, hold on. I have to change, it was my controller inside, which I have to get rid of, and obviously I have to put back in my flight thingy. There you go. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna load up the Rolls-Royce engine 757 and basically set up the flight from Los Angeles to Las Vegas as if it was real. I don't think I'm gonna actually do it, although you know me, I might end up actually doing that. No, I don't have that. Actually, I think I have on the TBM 850, I believe, I do have an E1000. You're talking about like a display, right? E1000 is the display, right? I do have that in one of the airplanes, I believe. But that's a resource hog. That's a resource hog. So I haven't been really using it, to be honest. But yeah, it can be gorgeous, but at the same time, I think it's very complicated. Oh, that is the Garmin G1000. Then what is the E1000? I don't know that. Epic E1000, what is that? I don't have it. No, I don't know what that is. Sorry about that. From here, you can see that I'm quite a noob. Sorry. So, Julian, are you ready to see that, or you are actually playing, so You won't be able to see that. Are you able to come and take a look what we're doing? I mean, I'm doing it for you, to be honest. So it would be great if you could be here. We might actually end up with a full flight. I'm not sure. Because you know me. I mean, technically speaking, I should be going to sleep right this moment. So that's why I'm kind of in between. But at the same time, I know myself that if I really get something, you know, I get something very interested in something, then I might end up. So we're gonna basically do the Rolls-Royce. Winglets on is okay, and let's start it up. Is there any reason you're sleeping so late? Yeah, basically a lot of empirical experience, I realized that this is the time when people are there. In other words, it's like you can try to sell shoes in Africa, in the Sahara, and those bloody locals, they just don't want to buy. And you can be very upset about it. But at the end of the day, you will realize that, well, they are not interested in it because, well, it's too hot, right? So anyway, so this is the one. And let's actually load things up. I'm not sure if there is anything different. So let's actually take a look here. I don't see anything different. So I'm going to leave everything here as it is. Optimize is 25, good. I'm going to put on, actually I don't need that, I have a gate configuration and a fuel truck, that's all I need. And we obviously need to open the door. So we're going to start loading the airplane. Alright, so let's take a look if there is any difference here. I'm going to actually go for the general and checklist. Oh yeah, there are some, I think I already see some differences here. So, well, let's see. Let's see if the checklist is going to be different here. I believe it should be. So amplified power up. Let's see what we have. Battery switch auto is the same, obviously. Standby power selector, auto. Landing gear, whatever, at the same. Electric power, we're going to say it's established. Actually, it's not really, but kind of. Bus tie switches. On. APU generator on and start. Next one. IRS. Now we have to wait for the display to see if there is anything different. I'm just gonna get rid of that. But by the way, guys, I don't know how many of you guys have seen right just now the NBA 2K17. What do you guys think about it? I think it's unbelievable. I'm in love with it, honestly. I'm in love with it. And up until now, I wasn't interested in my team and my GM pretty much, but I'm actually getting interested in this. So what I'm thinking of, I might actually end up dedicating maybe a day to it somewhere. So there would be one day when I play and it would be on my page. So if somebody doesn't like them, like you, Julian, then you wouldn't come on that day and everything would be still fine. Okay, we're good. And quantities are good. All right, check. Next one. Now I'm actually gonna do this. Let's do it the simplest way possible, which means pausing it. We are at KLAX, right? I think that's what I set up, right? KLAX, and there you go, route, KLAX, KLAS, Runway. Hold on. You guys cannot see what I'm doing. Hey, the skipjack, how are you doing? How did you finish the airplanes? What do you mean? How did you finish the airplanes? What do you mean? Oh, I don't get it. I don't know what you mean. You mean that how did I end up flying airplanes? Is that your question? Hold on. KLAX airport info. There you go. We're gonna probably take that 25R. Let's take 25R. Still flying on a Comanche, all right. 2 hour flying as of now, legally have 15 minutes, might even reach Marseille. Nice. You know, right now I'm very worried about long routes because 2 nights in a row it died on me. And that was really bad. Okay, so let's actually try to see. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use this view so that I can actually see it like this, and I'm gonna actually try to do different 25R. Let's go for 25R, which is the active. That's good. Let's try to see which one I know. SLI 7, I think I know this one. But that's what it's like with vectors. I'm trying to find one that doesn't have vectors. Not easy. That could be it. Hold on. This one and execute. Let's try to go for the legs and let's do step by step. KLAX and it just go like that. Okay. Let me try to see that a little bit closer. Okay, this is a very simple one. Extremely simple one. Okay. So Rocky, why does it say 6,801 miles? Aren't we at KLAX? Hold on. I think we are at KLAX, right? Yes, we are. So why is it saying 6,801 lakhs? I don't get it. Root. Next page. You know what? Let's go back. I'm not sure if it's a good one. Hold on. Let's go try to find another one. Let's go for SX. No, I want one without turn. Okay, you know, no. Okay, this one wouldn't work over there, so no. I'm just looking for something that I can fly. Without any. This could be good. Let's take a look at this. It's something that would probably not be the most economical way to go, but you know what? Let's do this one. Execute like this. There you go. Hey there, PC1, how are you doing? We are just trying out the Rolls-Royce engine basically. So 25R would be the takeoff thingy. And let's go through. Scenery or scenery? Execute. Okay, so let me actually see what it would mean. Lex again. Step, 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 step. Okay. Route again, just to make sure 25R. Okay. Lex execute. Oh no, steps. So runway and then okay, let's do this one. That's fine. Actually, let's do an arrival as well. Just why not? Arrival should be we already did the Kresso before. Let's do the Kresso with a deck and ILS 25 left. Transition preno, that's good. Okay, execute. Okay, and then the route would have definitely would have a big. Kressel deck. Previous page. Oh no. Oh no, hold it. Invalid. Sorry. Kresso deck would go to no. Never mind. Delete this. Here you go. Direct. Execute, all right, and next page. Everything is good, all right. So that's what you're gonna do here. Lex, basically, we're gonna go up like this, and that's we might actually finish it up. And we go to deck, and then we go over. Now, this is gonna be a little bit trickier if you wanna really do it. I might end up doing it, but basically, what we should do, we would actually go end up at bold. We would go from bold to preno. Right there, and then turn, and then basically take land over there. So, yeah, let's do that. Clear. All right. And then, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go for route and performance in invalid entry. Let's get rid of it. Cruising altitude, let's go for 31,000. No, let's go for 31,000. Cost index 30. Reserves 5. I think we already loaded here. Yes, good. And then the takeoff, we would have 5 flaps. Let's do a deterred 40. 25 CG. And that would need 130. 131, 137, 145. There you go. So, what? This room is now in 30 minutes followers only mode? No, let's not do that. We don't do that, Paddy. Thank you. I mean, what is strange, Julian? What is strange? So we are completing it. I think we're good. Oh, that's all right. So we're actually gonna go and check these things all out. Everything is good. We're gonna have a fun little flight. Next one, yo dumper switches. Let's see, everything is the same as, it looks everything is the same as before. Yo dumper switches. Oh, no. There are EEC switches have to be on. Now that's the difference. I have no idea where the EEC switches are. Oh, these ones. EEC switches 1, 2. There you go. That's an extra one. And then check. Left and right engine pump. Everything is okay. Utility bus switches there. Generator control switches on. Emergency light switch right there. Passenger check, check. Engine start selectors there. Engine limiter buttons. Now again, this is something on, on. There you go. We didn't have that before. I mean, there is the button was there, but I didn't use it. And I'm gonna do it like engine starts. I'm gonna put it both. I'm not sure if I should do it. Let's see. I don't know if it says anything about that. Position light switch on. Anti-collision off. Wing light switch, no need. Window heat. Non-smoking selector. Auto rate control, check. Landing earth selector. Now we have to go to KLAS. To open tab, and we're gonna take a look at 2180. So far there are a couple of differences, not too many actually. 2180, check. Mode selector auto. Cabin controls. Trim air, receiver fans, out packs, isolation on, which actually means we're gonna close the door as well. Gate conf and fuel trucks off. Plane is already loaded. Good. Now I'm not gonna use any announcements and everything. I'm just gonna leave it. Are you still there, Julian? I suppose. Oh, okay, Paddy. I did that. Yeah. Yeah, Paddy, thank you for the suggestion. I kind of made up my mind already how to do it. So check out on my page, and that's how I did it. I think it's cool. And I think it's good that I put like how many months? Does it make any sense to you? I think it's actually a good thing, right? Would love to have it more and more, obviously, but it's gonna be sometimes. I'm optimistic about that. Flight instruments check, so set the altimeter. Altimeter is 2994. Since we are not gonna do, probably not gonna do a full flight, we are not gonna use TOTOFD. We're not gonna use and I wanna make it quick, so I'm not gonna use radio or anything. I'm just gonna fly. ACoS display seems to be okay. Secondary engine seems to be okay. Status display on. Computer selector on. Thrust reference. It's actually not TO. We are using DTO, but both places. That's good. All these are gonna be standard. Communication ADF, engine fire panel. Transporter, I'm gonna put it on to RT snow. Yeah, like this, doesn't matter. ILS panel, I'm not even sure I should, but you know what? Since we are there anyway, I'm gonna do that. KLAS approach. Come on. Damn it. My Navigraph just died. Stupid. Yeah, I'm not sure. Maybe not. In other words, let's suppose you sub, okay? I'm gonna list the active and non-active ones separately. But actually at one point I might not, you know, let's suppose I get very lucky and I get 1,000 subscribers. That would be beautiful. It's not gonna happen. But let's suppose, okay? Let's suppose my channel blows up. I'm not gonna be able to list out like 1,000. So sorry guys, we are talking about my page right now with Paddy CT, Paddy C1, if you didn't know what he's talking about. So I'm gonna do pretty much again the same thing what I did with the top 10 donations and top 10 cheers. I'm gonna just simply put up the top 10 now. The way I'm gonna do the top 10 is, right now I don't have that many anyway. So when it more than 10, what I'm gonna do is actually right now I have like four people actually, four or five people I believe. What I'm gonna do is actually I'm gonna, based on, you know, I'm gonna put active and non-active, okay? Because maybe for example you sub me. And then you sub for 3 months and then you get off, but then you sub again after 5 months. You know, then basically I'm just calculating how many months you actually subbed. You know? So it might be active or non-active at one point, but if you are non-active, that's fine. But you might become active at any other time. So I'm gonna still list you because you did support me that way. But then again, I think I'm gonna calculate for each tier, like there are three tiers. Right now, there is no question because there is only one tier. But for each tier, I'm gonna count like how many months they were on, and based on that would be like a maximum, okay? And you know that the top five or top 10, and then you know, for example, if you are, let's say, everybody else is less than 10 months, and you sub for 15 months. And then you miss 2 months, you should still be on the top. You know what I mean? And then, you know, I just would make sure that active or non-active would be shown, you know. But right now I don't have this problem. I believe all the people who are there are actually active, so we will see. I haven't really thought about that much. But for the donations and the cheers, I already made my decision, so that's how I did it, and I think it's gonna be okay. Yes, exactly. That's what it is, exactly. Exactly. Yeah, I mean, what the exact wording would be, that's kind of irrelevant, if you know what I mean. It really doesn't matter, but that's exactly what I'm talking about. So KLAS, I go to approach, and I think, no, not this one. 25, no, it's not that, hold on. 25R, I said, right? No, 25, did I put 25L or 25R? R to go and 25L to land. All right, 25L. So I'm gonna find the 25L ILS. There you go. And that one has 111.75255. 111.75255. Even though, as I said, probably I'm not gonna use it, but just in case, 255. Hey, welcome back, Commander. Well, Paddy C1, I wouldn't use the word patrons because they are used, you know, like with pay. It could be confused with the patron system, which is a totally different one. Alright, so I wouldn't use that, I guess. But it's really, you know, as I said, right now I don't even wanna really think about it because it's too far away. Non-controlling, let's go for the VOR, DMI, FD on, auto throttle. Julian, everything is so far the same as yours. Bank limit selector, check. Everything is there. Altitude indicator, caging out. Check. Flap lever, check. Parking brake, okay. Check. There you go. And before start, we can do that as well. Flight deck door is closed. CDU, both of them are showing DTO and here. DTO, so check, IAS box, check, IAS max selector there, LNAV on, initial heading. Now I'm gonna take a look at that takeoff there, hold on, KLAX, SID, and we were talking about, what is the SID? Which SID are we using? Hold on. We are using DOTSS1. DOTSS1. So SID DOTSS1 RNAV departure. That's gonna be initial is 251 in either case. So initial heading is 251. Okay, and yes, initial altitude, I'm gonna put it as 31,000. We're just gonna go and shoot for it. Right, doors closed. Now hydraulic panel, Electric motors all on. Pumps all on. Actually, I'm not even sure I would need these, but whatever. Doesn't seem to hurt. Recall switch. Nothing special. Trim has to be 3.8. Something like that. Check. All right. Next, engine start. So we're actually going to go and do a pushback here. All right. We're going to do a pushback. Now, this pushback is going to be kind of tricky because our space here is extremely limited. So let's try to do that. Now, what we do here is, as we get rid of the parking brake, the gate goes away. Nice. And actually, I'm going to go a little bit higher here so that I can see better. And I'm just going to try to push back here nicely. A little bit first this way. Too much. But then, basically this way. Turn, 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 turn. We're gonna be pretty close to the other one, but that's all right. All right, let's just stop here. Let's just have this on. And let's just push back, go. All right, we're safe, good. Pushback cart is done, good. That's all right, Petty Steven, no problem. We are all a little family here, so we're good. Secondary engine conditions are okay, as I mentioned. Yes, check. So this is where we're gonna see what's going on, all right? Pack control selectors off. Left engine ground. And we're looking for N3, this one here actually, for to go for 25. 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. And let's see what's going on. Let's take a look outside. All right, we are already working pretty tough and I believe we already spooled back, so we can actually verify that. A little guess, we'll do that. Let's go for the other side. Same thing, let's go for 25. So far, so good. So far, we are alive. 22, 23, 24, 25. Spooling up, but kind of staying there. Spools up. All right. And everything seems to be nicely in the green. I don't see any heating or any problem right now. And I believe we are also, we can also verify. Perfect. We are idling. Perfect. Next, before taxi, let's get rid of the APU selector. Anti-ice back controls. The hell? Sorry, my mouse played with me. Isolation switch. Let's take a look at the status display. Only a parking brake thing is there. Flap lever, this time we're gonna put down to 5%. Flight controls. Good. Oh, by the way, we almost forgot. This one should be sent to the other side as well. Flap lever and flight controls, good. Check. Taxi lights. I know they are not taxi lights, but I call them taxi lights because they practically are. Next. All right. And we're gonna... We're basically ready. Actually, we're ready to go. Okay, what is that? Parking brake, APU generator off. Yes, it's gonna disappear. All right, we're good. So let's actually go on taxi. Everything is good. I'm good. I'm good. Let's go. Let's taxi. Okay, so all we have to do is come on, man. I was told that this engine is way stronger than the other one. I never tried, so I believe, but I don't know, I don't have any experience with it. They sound pretty cool though. So we are right now flying with the Rolls-Royce engine. And so far so good. So far everything is good. I intentionally suggested a route that is 100% via, you know, just automatic VNAV thing. Nope, Perry, no, not right now. Because I'm just testing it. And the reason that we test it is because Julian told me that every time he tries to take off, for him, it's gonna blow up. Now, you know, I think it's better if we tested something. Hold on, give me a quick second here. I wanna take a look at something, KLAX, and I'm gonna take a look at the airport. So we're gonna actually go for C. Let's go with Bravo, actually. I think it's better if we are taxiing on Bravo. So I'm gonna go. Well, I believe we are good, because technically speaking, we are still, you know, we are still just taxiing, which is nothing really using a lot. So we should be fine. We are not taking off yet, you know. Anyway, I'm just doing it as I would normally. I didn't say anything to wait, to be honest. So I'm like, since it doesn't tell me to wait, I'm not waiting. I understand that you say that they kind of told you that you have to do that. I hear that, but right now I kind of ignore it on purpose. All right, some buses around. That's kind of funny. Because I'm just gonna basically go to follow the whatever I see the instructions, and I'm gonna just go by them. Yeah, Julian, exactly. We're gonna see. I mean, as I said, I'm not assuming that you're doing anything wrong, you know? So if you are not doing anything wrong, and you experience what you say you experience, it, you know, I might experience the same thing, you know? So, we'll see. Like, actually, I saw some, in some forums, people were saying that, oh, I like the 727 because it finally, my engines are not bursting into flames when I take off. So apparently you are not the only person having some kind of issue. It's just, we'll see, all right? Anyway, as I said, you know, my original idea is that we're just gonna try to take off. It might be a short flight. If our engines actually really blow, you know, really blow up, then it will be a short flight, and then I officially just stay with the other type, what I always fly, because I'm not gonna fly with something that is randomly breaking up or blowing up. But if everything is good, we might just keep going and actually go to Las Vegas, because we do have beautiful scenery, we have beautiful everything. Let me actually see something, my plugins. I don't have, hold on, right now my, I don't have the SkyMax Pro though. I don't know, my friend, I don't know. That's what I'm saying. I don't know. We'll just see. Like, for example, Julian, are you using auto throttle to take off, or you're using like actual manual throttling? That's actually a very valid question, I believe. Because, like, you know what? Even on the Caravan, I once blew up the engine, like in the very beginning. When it was one of my first flights, I went to the Caravan and I blew up the engine. Simply because I just went full throttle just to take off, like boom, just going. And then it died. Like a really painful death. Like, bye. SS in the Caravan. So, you know, think about a big thing like this. On the Cessna Caravan, all you have to do is just have they have like a little red mark that this is the takeoff power. It's like fixed, but on an airplane like this, I would assume that, you know, there are so many different variables that probably you cannot do that. By the way, guys, if anybody here hasn't followed me yet, please do so. Just hit the follow button. Feel free to also sub or cheer or whatever you want to do, but the most important, hit the follow button and stay and talk. Let's have some chat. We are trying to take off with the Rolls-Royce engine, with the 757, which I never tried before. Now, if it works out nice, I might actually end up doing it more often. We'll see, because I was told that the Rolls-Royce engine is actually like flying, you know, it's much more powerful and, you know, whatever. So maybe I'm just gonna start flying the Rolls-Royce engine. I don't know. Or the other thing is, did you use the limiters, Julian? These ones. Did you turn these on, left and right limiters, and these two as well? Well, I bite sometimes, but you know, I mean, come on, just a little bite. Just a little taste, you know? All right, let's go for before takeoff. White engine collision thing, transponder. Actually, I don't need it, but why not? Auto brake, we do need it. Taxi lights and that. Okay, and next is gonna be actually after takeoff, it's gonna be just as normal basically every time. All right guys, so as we say in Hungarian, this is where the monkey jumps into the water. We will take a look and see what happens. All right, my friend here says that his airplane is basically a time bomb when he does this. Let's see if it works for us. So it's gonna be 1000 and about 100 something when I can actually activate VNAV. Until then we just go without it. I don't know, I mean it makes some sense, you know. This is when the monkey jumps into the water, you know, we will see what happens. I mean, to be honest, do monkeys swim? I don't know, I mean, I guess. I think they should be able to swim, but however, not all people swim, so maybe monkeys cannot swim, I don't know. Can monkeys swim? I don't know, come on, man. Don't be shy, go. All right, so let's line up and let's actually go. I hope that it's the runway and it's not the, we are not doing a reverse, what's his name, George Harris, Harrison Ford. No, this seems to be the runway, good. All right, and the takeoff speed is 137. So I'm just gonna give some power and go for auto throttle right away. We are still in, we are not even going into the red, yellow right now, so we're good. We'll see later. 100, 110, 20, 30, 37. Actually, we should have taken up a little bit earlier. Like, what is this? What is the thing is up. All right, and we're off. And our engine doesn't seem to be blowing up, my friend, at all. I think we're good. We look good. I think we're looking good, my friend. Now this time my look at that. All the things are in the green, not even in the yellow, not even in the yellow, not even in the yellow. We're good, Julian. I don't know. And by the way guys, the only thing that is not nice right now is that we have, unfortunately, I don't have SkyMax Pro on right now, so we have this standard these are the standard X-plane11 clouds. They are not really horrendous, to be honest, but they are okay, but not something I love. So far we're good, Julian, I don't know. Well, me neither, but it just came up, right? So I thought we would have to kind of answer that question at one point. All right, so climb about 240. We are about 239. Perfect, about 240. We still have 64 miles to get up to cruising altitude. Hey, Dunk. Hey, Dunton. How are you doing, my friend? I was told by Julian that they would, but they don't look like it. I mean, if you take a look, everything is outside of the yellow area here, so they look perfect to me. Nothing is overloaded, nothing is too hot, so I don't know, I'm happy so far. 10,000, so we're gonna actually go and turn off the landing lights. I'm gonna actually have little lights. I should have turned them on originally, but that's fine. On. We can actually tell our people to...
Ladies and gentlemen, our aircraft continues to climb. We would like to remind you that all flights of our airline are non-smoking.
Looks good to me, honestly.
Have been equipped with smoke detectors.
I'm good. Hey there, Vivid AJ, how are you doing? Okay, I'm sorry, we cannot listen to that thing. So, I don't know, these clouds are not that bad, but obviously way worse than the SkyMax Pro ones. However, hopefully, by using these ones, we hopefully can avoid 100% that our X-plane11 would die. Thank you, Vivid. That's very kind of you to say something like that. We are in the sour cream. I know in English it's called soup, but have you seen a soup like this? This is not soup, this is sour cream, my friend. And we got over. Actually, it doesn't look that bad, to be honest. It's just obviously not as good as SkyMax Pro, that's all. But actually, I think it looks pretty decent, if you ask me. Let's take a look at everything. Everything is still outside of the yellow area. You see? Yellow, 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 yellow. Everything is outside, so I think we're good. Honestly, I think we're good. $18,000, which means that we're gonna go and 299R2, which means that this checklist is officially checked off. Next one is already gonna be at descending. I don't know what's going on, my friend. Do I know you, Vivid AJ? Yeah, the skipjack. I'm kind of puzzled myself, so... What do you guys think about these clouds? These are the standard clouds. Oh no, You know what? I start to figure out what's going on. I didn't know we were depth attack. Yeah, the skipjack. Yeah, precisely. I don't know what's going on. Yeah, they are actually not that bad, but I mean, when you see the SkyMax Pro clouds compared to them, it's like totally different. You met me on a train where? Where was that train? At minimum, which country? Gromit? What is Gromit? Oh, Gromix, you mean? What? No, I don't. I'm sorry, the skipjack. Who are those people? I really don't know. Yeah, you know what? I think these look actually all right. The difference is, however, when you are flying with... that would be very interesting. Because I haven't been on a train in Hungary for about... I would say about 28 years. So are you saying that we met more than 28 years ago and you still remember me? That's good. I'm touched. Well, apparently 28 years ago, I mean, you know, he cannot remember that long, right, Paddy, so... Ah, okay. Gotcha. Makes sense. Makes perfect sense. Right. Ask your son or daughter. He or she must be over 30 years old, and I vividly remember that I didn't rape anybody on a train. I kind of remember that. I mean, you know, that's something that probably wouldn't slip your mind if you did. I'm just thinking, you know? Yeah, thank you. I don't mind a little craziness, my friend. I mean, crazy people are human beings too, but, I mean, come on. It doesn't look so bad, as I said. The biggest problem, actually, with the standard X-plane11 clouds is that they are like cotton candy, you know, like a big chunk is together. And also, they don't have like a body, they are more like flattish layers. Other than that, actually, they don't look that bad. Look at that, we're actually flying. Look at this whole circle we are actually making here. And we're gonna make a big turn sometimes, because obviously we wanna go up there to Las Vegas is somewhere like there, so we're gonna make a pretty sharp turn, about 90 degrees up there at one point, but this is our takeoff right now. It's pretty cool. I mean, it actually looks, it doesn't look that bad, to be honest, but it's like when you already had SkyMax Pro and you see this, you feel like, nah, it doesn't look good. If you haven't had SkyMax Pro before, then actually it looks brilliant, you know? Wow, we're still going to the right a little bit. And look at that, we're actually gonna... That's when we're gonna make a huge turn over there. This is still all our, basically, we are still taking off, even though we're already at altitude, we are at the right altitude, so I'm just gonna go for... Wait, why can't I hear it? I want to listen to the announcement. I cannot hear. Oh, okay, the announcement ended, that's why. Alright. But this is how somebody would see it. This stupid thing is closed, which is annoying. It's kind of random, but we can actually just simply skid over to the other side. And look out to the engine, basically. That's the big old Rolls-Royce engine. There you go, look at that. We have some nice weather coming up. Nice! Oh, I spoke too quickly. Sorry. Yes, the problem is that they are still there, even if you turn off the dynamic, whatever, they are still there, so it's kind of annoying. Alright, give me a quick second, guys. I need to go to the toilet. Pretty quickly. I'll be back in just a second, alright? Alright, so Julian, are you still there? I think it's safe to say that our engines didn't blow up. I don't know, I mean, feel free to contest that statement, but it really seems to me that our engine is intact. Which means that we should be fine. This is freaking gorgeous, man. Now, this is not a mistake here. The clouds are normally really just to this point. X-plane 11, my friend. I think it's the beta 02 or something. Or 022, I don't know. Yeah, 11. Oh, this is so cool. Normally, if you are coming from San Diego, I believe these are the hills that we have to come through. Are they? I think, I'm not sure. Hold on, let me take a look at it. Yeah, pretty much. If you take a look, when we are in San Diego, these are the hills that we are coming through, and we see this lake. However, the direction is we would come from this side. So practically, what we see here, we are actually going this way, we would go south, right? So I believe we're gonna make a big turn in a second and we're gonna go back there. So if you continue this way here, up here, and about somewhere here, I think this is the one. If you come this way, like to the north, you basically can go to the I-10. I believe is this one here. Not 100% sure, but I think so. I think that's the one over here, or yeah, it should be that one. Actually, you're right, Paddy Sivan. I think even the clouds look actually pretty nice. I was told that actually clouds are looking better and better. Because they used to look like very dark from whatever angle you were looking at them. And that's kind of gone. So they actually look better than before. So yeah, normally we would actually come from San Diego, is somewhere there. Hold on. San Diego is about there. And we would normally come through these hills and end up actually somewhere like there. You would come over and then come up here. So I know this lake, like I flew my Cessna 172 Caravan and whatnot already a lot of times here in this area. Never a 755 though. Never a 757 though. We're gonna make a pretty sharp turn in a minute, but in the meantime, let's just enjoy how beautiful this is, guys. It's absolutely gorgeous, isn't it? Actually, it can look very, very nice from about, you know, just let's say 3,000 feet. Above 3,000 feet, it looks gorgeous. If it's very low, it's not that good, but about 3,000 feet or something, 2,000-3,000 feet, I would say 2,000. After 2,000 feet, it's actually gorgeous. We're actually gonna turn back pretty much like that. I think this is actually the eye turn here, right here. Or that one? I'm not sure. Maybe this one. You can look up the... or there? No, I think this is the one. I think this is I-10 there. You say it's a double. It's a double road. It's a. It's a. It's a highway. It looks gorgeous, I think. And as I said, the clouds here actually, you know, they look good, but they don't look really real, you know what I mean? I mean, the clouds look nice, but not real. And when you have SkyMax Pro, they actually look real. So that's still a big difference for me. We're gonna make a big turn in a second, that's why I'm preparing for that. If you take a look, oh, here you go. We are just making the turn, I think. And it's going to be a pretty decent turn, what we make. Now, the engine is quite loud, I know. First of all, I set it quite loud itself. The second of all is... I mean, I don't know how loud is it for you. It is for you, because I think my headphone was set to quite loud as well, so... Oh, it's not the big turn yet. Hold on. If I go here... You see, that's the big turn what we're gonna make in a minute. It's still a little distance, though. It's like 10 miles away when we actually start to make a huge turn. But then again, 10 miles is quite quick, you know? It takes a couple of minutes. So, Julian, I have a feeling... Did you use auto throttle to... I mean, did you do anything different from what I did? Basically, that's the question. When you were... What I was doing, you could see everything, right? Did you do anything different? You have to basically have the EEC on. You have to basically have the engine limiters on. And you have to, when you go up, you have to use the auto throttle and all the V1, V2, V3 speeds and everything. If you do everything like that, I mean, I know that I have some friends who were complaining that the Whitney and Prattle is not good because it's too weak and whatever. He's been flying the Rolls-Royce quite a few times. Or you didn't use auto throttle. That's probably the problem. I would tell you 100% that's the problem. Because you probably gave it way more throttle than you needed. Well, you still need to have the auto throttle. I use derated takeoff as well. I use derated takeoff, but at the same time, I'm using the auto throttle, and I believe it's 100% needed. Now, this is going to be a nice big turn right here. It sounds awesome, guys. Sounds so... Actually, I agree with my friend that it sounds so much better than the other one. Having said that, that one is... I was told that it's also realistic. Yeah, because I believe that you probably gave way more throttle than you needed. Okay? That's my honest opinion. Having said that, you see, I don't claim to be an expert in this, so I can only do it empirically. In other words, I can do it and can show you that there is no problem. Other than that, you're on your own, to be honest. Oh, okay, I see, no problem. Yeah, on P3D, right? I saw the thing on the Discord. pretty decent big turn, but it's not going to do a steep turn because people are paid customers, so it makes a big, big turn around here. Oh, you did? Let me take a look, hold on. Oh, you put it in the silly pictures. Is it? No. Where did you put it? Hold on. Where did you put it? In general? Oh, yeah. Okay, I saw it. Okay, good. Nice. Cool. Yeah, got it, found it. Look at that turn, man. And by the way, we're gonna have another big turn somewhere around here. We're gonna turn around like this. So it's gonna be, it's not really a sensible flight, if you know what I mean. Actually, we are turning about this direction, but I think we overturned so that we can turn back there, like, legit. Now, what I'm gonna do is... Screw that, I think we gotta go and finish this flight, so... I'm actually starting some music, but guys, basically we're gonna have 100%, what is it, I'm gonna have, what's your name, Commander Creel, you're gonna basically, alright, take care, the Skipjack, thank you so much for dropping by. YouTube is not gonna like it, but whatever. Oh no, we have all... You see, this is the problem with SkyMax Pro. That with the standard clouds. On SkyMax Pro, I promise you, you would just have some clouds and you would see the whole ground. And with the standard ones, it's basically covered with a cotton candy. And that for me is actually kind of a deal breaker. We actually only 83 miles and we actually start descending. So let's actually see where we're gonna descend to. Basically 3,800. Sometimes, yeah, I do. Actually, but right now I want to be able to say that I fly the 757 100% happily and confidently, and then I would go to something else. Like I have already a few airplanes that I still want to learn, like the B-200, the PC-12. Actually, I'm probably going to get the Baron with the real-life add-on, and I want to learn that, like, really. So there are quite a few airplanes that I want to get on, but when it comes to airliners, I think this is the only one that I have right now, and the only one that I really want to go for. And then when I feel very happy with it, I'm thinking about a couple of different ones. The 737 Zeebo one, the CRG 200, the Dash 800. Like, there are quite a few tube liners that I'm looking at. Yeah, I should be sleeping. Welcome back, Perisigon. Wow. Cool. I think it's still pretty beautiful, isn't it? I think so. I like it. Welcome to the channel, anybody who is coming right now. We are basically heading to Las Vegas. It was just a little trial originally to see if we are blowing up or not on takeoff. Apparently we are not, which is great to know. I think it's gorgeous, guys. Literally everything have from BMDG and FS Lab. Wow, you are a rich person. They call a fucking $1 million, excuse me, but they call $1 million, man. Wow, you're loaded, man. Okay, that's a big other turn that we're gonna have here, I believe. Not sure how big. Yeah, look at that. We have this pretty big turn, actually, and we are actually getting close to, not too far. That's the top of this end is right there already. Yeah, I mean, those add-ons cost a lot of money, man. You're loaded. You're loaded. I know it now. Listen to that. Oh my goodness. That engine actually does look really good. Well, shitty actually, because I should be probably sleeping, so I might end up taking off the day or something, I'm not sure, we'll see. There is one thing I like about the X-plane 11 weather, and that you can see very far clouds. SkyMax Pro is just a vicinity where you are, and that's it. Yeah, that's what I'm saying, you know, that part I actually like more than SkyMax Pro. That you can look quite far. That is really good, I like that. So, with all fairness, that's actually a good thing. Hallelujah, in up your own backyard. Nice. Clean up your own backyard. Clean up your own backyard. Wait a minute. We are already coming down. Are you serious? Hold on. Yeah, scared the shit out of me. I was like, okay, 855, that's it, we're there? No. We still have these. In a pure room backyard. Clean up your own backyard. Yes, Petty Sivan, but I apologize. I'm actually gonna stop the music right now. Because I have to pay attention to the engine sounds and everything as we're getting closer. So, sorry about that. And I believe this is gonna be the... this is gonna be basically the view that you guys gonna see. Pretty much until we get down. I'm sorry about that. I think it's still beautiful. You can see, still see everything. But this is what the pilot would see anyway. So if you wanna go realistically, this is how you should look at things, you know. As the pilot is here, that's what he sees, you know. At one point, as you can see actually on my goal, I'm actually starting to save up for a Vive. And if at one point I can have a VR thingy, which most probably gonna be the Vive, I would love to actually, I might be able to actually, you know, use that and watch, you know, use it with VR. In this case, I'll look at there, look up, do something there, look there, you know, the whole thing is like in 3D. That would be awesome. Alright guys, so we are already descending. Actually, that means that we should actually do this checklist. Which is the pressure is good, check. Let's take a look if there is anything happened here. Nothing, check. Auto brake, we actually set it to 2 already, check. Landing data, we actually double check here. 128 actually, and 25 flaps, check. Approach briefing, check. Basically, we're gonna use the ILS. Go back there and let's just see where we are. So it hopefully is still going to be beautiful, guys, but I apologize that I won't be able to show you guys much more. You know, I won't be able to show you outside right now. I wish I could. But I think it's beautiful, isn't it? I mean, look at that. Just look at this whole area. It does look beautiful. Actually, I'm gonna pull back the speed a little bit. To about 250. 240 actually. I'm gonna slow down now already. Not 250. Let's slow down about 250. Actually, these clouds don't look that bad, if you ask me. They look much better than they used to, and I was told that they are still trying to improve them. So at one point, maybe they're gonna be just as good as SkyMax Pro. So then, why would you need them, right? Okay, I'm gonna have a little. I'm using some speed brake. Go it down to about 240. However, I'm gonna get rid of it now. I think it's good. Yeah, I think so, but you know, some people like it from the outside, so. But you know, it's really, if you wanna do like a hardcore, like, simulator, this is the only view you should see, okay? Now, actually, let's take a look at Las Vegas. And we're gonna have Ultimate 2991. So actually, I'm just gonna change it to 2991. Which is a very tiny change anyway. I'm actually gonna go down to like 220. Because we are actually way above the flight path that we are supposed to make. So I want to go back down there. Here. It looks beautiful, isn't it? Actually, this clouds. I don't know. I might actually just keep it like this, you know? I might just end up not having SkyMax Pro at all. And who knows? Maybe that actually gonna... Oh, okay. Hold on. Give me a quick second. We are still quite high, so I'm actually going to go down to 220. I mean 200. But that means that I'm going to actually go and put down one flap. Where are you going? I have one flap down, but I have to watch out, because if it speeds up again, we're gonna be in trouble. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna actually go to... go down by 2500, which, however, means... I'm gonna... put on some speed brakes. I cannot go too high. Probably 200 is a little bit too slow, but I think it's fine. I mean, we need to get down, way down, and we are still above our flight path. I'm gonna... I'm gonna put off one flap. I'm gonna put the flap down, up. I don't wanna end up having a problem with that. But I'm trying to get back down to my altitude here. 240 already. That's okay, because we have to be at 240 at 9333, so that's okay, but it's still not... it's not going down quickly enough, I believe. Actually, I think we do have a little... we should be all... okay, we should be okay. What is our speed? 248. Down to 2... okay, that's good. Okay, so let's actually go back to about 2000. Which will slow us down nicely. I mean, technically, we could go for VNAV actually. 233. Oh, no, 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 no. No, let's go. No, no, no. Alright, let's just go down to. Actually, you know what? Let's do it differently. Let's go up to... we are at 8,000. And I'm gonna do actually a flight level change. There you go. It's gonna be easier, however, we have to watch the speed. I'm gonna slow down to about 200. And we're gonna go down to 6,500. Heading like that. Have to go like this and... hey, thank you so much for the follow, my friend. D-bomb 22. Since it's 128, I'm gonna actually go to... go one flap. I mean, we are at 200. And as we go there, we're gonna go for... direct. LAR direct execute and LNAV. We are at 6500, that's good. We actually have to stay above 6500 at that point. Let's go actually to about 180. Which means that we're gonna put down 5 flaps. In it, ref, we have to be at 128.25, so that's good. Nine, that's 14, 18. Okay, I'm gonna actually go this one. I'm gonna 4,900. And I'm gonna have this actually go down. Actually, hold on, let's go down to 170 though. Alright. Alright, actually let's just put the localizer in and both of them actually on lock and lock is there, approach, is it up? We haven't got that yet, we're getting it in a second. Let's just slow down actually to 3,800. Oh, it doesn't really matter because it's not it's already following it in a second. Oh wait, we have to be at 3,800 to actually see it. Why? We're good, my friend, we're good. Lock there, and we are still looking for a GS, but we are already heading towards the airport, and we should be perfect, guys. We should be perfect. Speed wise, 170, let's go back to about 150. Let's go down to about 15. Oh, hold on. We actually have to go down all the way to 129, about 130 something. Alt hold, I said lock and lock in there, man. Come on. There you go, now you are in GS, that's right. 135. Actually, we have to go down to putting down the landing gear. It's gonna slow us down nicely. 20. And 25. There you guys, there you go guys, we are already seeing the runway, everything is good. We are nicely going down to the It's going to be 2180 or something, so it's way about 900 high. I'm going to actually get rid of the autopilot at this moment. Autopilot off. All right, that was not nice. It was a hard landing, but landing nevertheless, not crashing. 377. Not gonna be proud of it, but it's gonna be still okay. Altimeters, they are mismatching, I think. That's fine. Oh, auto brakes. Oh, auto brakes. Okay. All right, so well, 377. We're gonna take a look at it in a second, how it actually happened. But at least we didn't jump or anything. So yeah, it wasn't as good as it should have been. I had better ones before, but it wasn't that horrible. Oh, the landing lights weren't there. So it was not so good, but wasn't that bad. APU generator is already on. Let's start it. Verify it. Okay. Gonna get rid of that. Check. Flap up. Transponder standby. It was a hard but okay landing, I would say. All right, and let's actually see where we can. Here is the only problem I have. This is what I have. I don't have anything. I don't have any scenery here, unfortunately, so I think that's where we have to go there. So we're gonna go here, go through there, and as we go there, we're basically gonna park our airplane somewhere there. Okay, so let's actually go. So yeah, it wasn't that good, but honestly, it wasn't that bad either. It wasn't horrendous. But we're gonna take a look. I'm gonna take a look at from the outside, and we're gonna actually see how good or bad it was. All right. I mean, yeah, I've done better landings than this before. I agree with you guys. But anyway, it was just a quick dirty flight. Anyway, the whole purpose was checking the engines if they are blowing up at takeoff. And you know what, Julian? I'm just joking, but you know what? I think it was a better flight than yours when you blew up the engine. Don't you agree? I mean, you know. Just saying. Hold on. Actually, that's, I think that's where I'm going. Hold on. I'm actually gonna go over there. What the hell? What was that? What was that sound? You land better with one engine. Congratulations, my friend. I'm still learning this airplane. But then again, 377 actually for an airplane like this, honestly, is not that bad. I did 170 last time, so yeah, I know I can land nicer than this, but I think what I did was I cut off the auto throttle a little bit too early. That's what happened. And because of that, I basically ended up a little bit having my nose going down. And then when I corrected it, it was already... I managed to correct it, but it was like a little bit too late. I think that's what more or less happened. Yeah, you mean that when your one engine is flaming and the other is like barely hanging on, but you are still landing nicer, right? Yeah, I can hear that. I believe you. I believe you. You barrend. This is such a beautiful airplane. So I know I shouldn't really abuse it like this, but whatever. Come on, it wasn't that bad. We're gonna take a look at it in a second in a replay, okay? So hold on. Don't run away. I'm just gonna park this baby, shut it down as it's supposed to be, and then... Who is... Oh, okay. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, we should do like a shared cockpit thingy. I'm really interested in doing that. I'm just gonna simply stop here because I don't know where I can, so I'm gonna assume that this is a gate here, which probably it is not, but whatever. We're gonna take a look at the landing in a second. I think it was fair enough. Honestly, I don't think it was that bad. Hey, but Emilio is not here, unfortunately. Or are you? Emilio, are you there? All right. All right, I'm just gonna stop right here. Assuming that this is the place I have to stop, I have no idea. So, parking brake set, antias, okay, fuel controls. Simply turn off and the seatbelt selectors can be off so people can get out of here. Fuel pump switches off. Red anti-collision off. Isolation switch off. I mean on, sorry. Flight director switches off. Wheel chocks on. Now before we go to the flight deck door, let's go here. Hydraulic panel, fuel pumps off, flaps up, parking bits, yes, all good. Let's go for security. Actually, we actually have to open the door here because we haven't done that yet. get some stairs, get some passenger buses, get some fuel trucks, and unload the airplane. Right. What do you guys think? How was the flight? Honestly. I mean, as I said, we're going to take a look at that landing, but other than that, what do you guys think? Was it fair enough? Why are my flaps... Wait. I put my flaps up. Why are they down? That's kind of weird. I think it was all right, right? Yeah, thank you. All right, you know what? Let's just actually secure the airplane, screw the customers. I mean, they are, as they are taking off, I'm actually shutting down the lights over their heads, but whatever. Check. Emergency lights. Off. Window heat. Packs. That's what the customers won't like, because that means no more aircon. There is no... let's put the GPU there, so... Available. So the APU can be off. Standby power selector can be... off. And the battery can be... off. There you go. Now, technically speaking, everything else I should just simply... We are just turning off everything, basically, what we see. As I said, people are not probably not happy because they end up getting off a dead airplane, but whatever, the doors are already open, so they should be alright. Alright, I think we're good, right? I think everything is turned off here. How about here? Well, there are a couple of things we would have to still do, but whatever. Yeah, I think good. So let's actually close the doors. Plane is not loaded. All the chocks have to stay. GPU, passenger bus stop. Door closed. There you go. I think we're good. Now, let's take a look. I don't know what else. This one has to come back here. I don't know what else. I think we are more or less, that's it. I don't think we turned on anything else. Probably the wars are... I don't know. Anyway, let's just go and do a replay mode. Not that bad, but yeah, not at the time that I should, I believe. Okay, so this is already basically getting ready for our landing. We are going, as you can see, down, but not... Hold on, man. We are not leaving yet. It is when we actually got ILS right here. So landing gears up. Wow, we do have some crabbing actually going on. Alright, let's take a look from here. Let's see how we did it. Obviously, we floated way too long, so that part was bad. Okay, we should have got down way earlier. Oh! Okay, you know what? That was pretty bad. I agree with you. We actually touched the ground a little bit. And then we kind of went like, fuck it, burn. All right, nope, there was no taste track, nope. Our tail was absolutely safe, but that was an ugly landing actually. No. Honestly, has it been gone, it would already say tire blown. You know, it's very sensitive to that, so no, I don't think so. I'm not saying that customers enjoyed this landing, but I think it was all right. All right, so let's actually go and take a look at this crazy landing. Let's take a look at this crazy landing from another view. From the tower. So yeah, it wasn't nice, but it was a landing, nevertheless, not crashing. Alright, give me a second and I will ask what that means, because I don't understand. What do you mean by over-input the airplane? Let's take a look at from this. Oh no, come on. No, 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 no. Okay. What does it mean? Oh, yeah. I agree. The problem with that was that I was high. And I think I stopped the... the auto throttle. And look at that. Look at that. We are actually crabbing like crazy, as a matter of fact. Yeah, I could have stayed. Oh, let me show you. I could have stayed about this angle all the time, and it could have been just good. There was no need for putting the nose that much up. I think we all agree. Anyway, As I said, the main issue was here, the only reason we actually did this flight, to check if our engines, but as you can see, let me show you just, Julian, one engine, two engines, neither of them is on flames, so the test was successfully conducted. All right, that's what we did, and I think that's more or less where I'm gonna end up today, if you don't mind. Feel free to, if you are here and you haven't followed me yet, please follow me, and feel free to do any kind of other hype. As I said, feel free to sub if you want. I would suggest using GameWisp, which is under the video, because then if you have FFC and you have FFC AP, then you can see all these great looking emojis. And in any case, thank you so much for coming, and let me actually see if we can send you guys over to somewhere. Who are we gonna say hello to? Because I think I really have to hit the bed. Wow, quite a few. Let's go over to Verdutz, guys. I don't know, I like Verdutz. So let's go over to Verdutz, and I'm gonna send you guys over. And please tell him mature raid, all right? All right? Thank you, guys, and I see you guys later, all right? Bye-bye.